Sudan is an African country in the Nile Valley of North Africa, bordered by Egypt to the north, the Red Sea, Eritrea and Ethiopia to the east, South Sudan to the south, the Central African Republic to the southwest, Chad to the west and Libya to the northwest. It is the third largest country in Africa. The River Nile divides the country into eastern and western halves, and its predominant religion is Islam. The country's place name Sudan is a name given to a geographic region in the south of the Sahara, stretching from western to eastern Central Africa. The name derives from the Arabic Bilad as Sudan, or the lands of the blacks, an expression denoting West Africa and northern Central Africa. Sudan was home to numerous ancient civilizations, such as the Kingdom of Kush, Kema, Nubatia, Alodia, Makuria, Mero, and others, most of which flourished along the Nile. Sudan was the largest country in Africa and the Arab world until 2011, when South Sudan separated into an independent country following an independence referendum. The politics of Sudan takes place in the framework of a presidential representative democratic consociationalist republic, where the president of Sudan is head of state, head of government, and commander-in-chief of the Sudanese armed forces in a multi-party system. Its current president is Omar Hassan Ahmad al-Bashir, who was re-elected in April 2015 in an election that was largely boycotted by opposition parties. Born on January 1, 1944, al-Bashir is the head of the National Congress Party. Al-Bashir joined the Sudanese army in 1960. Al-Bashir studied at the Egyptian Military Academy in Cairo and also graduated from the Sudan Military Academy in Khartoum in 1966. He came to power in 1989 when, as a brigadier in the Sudanese army, he led a group of officers in a military coup that ousted the democratically elected government of Prime Minister Sadiq al-Mahdi after it began negotiations with rebels in the south. Since then, he has been elected three times as president. In March 2009, al-Bashir became the first sitting president to be indicted by the International Criminal Court ICC for allegedly directing a campaign of mass killing, rape, and pillage against civilians in Darfur. A second arrest warrant for President al-Bashir was later issued on July 12, 2010. Al-Bashir oversaw the war in Darfur that began in February 2003 when the Sudan Liberation Movement, SLM, and Justice and Equality Movement, JEM, rebel groups began fighting the government of Sudan, which they accused of oppressing Darfur's non-Arab population. Al-Bashir says he takes full responsibility for the conflict in Darfur, but that his critics should recognize that his government did not start the fighting and has done all it can to end it. Bashir has been widely criticized by the international community since he took over as president, especially for his handling of the Darfur war, but he has overseen many achievements that have benefited his country. From the early 1990s, when he became president, his regime was at odds with larger U.S. foreign policy in the region. In the early 1990s, al-Bashir's administration gave the green light to float a new currency called Sudanese dinar to replace the battered old Sudanese pound that had lost 90% of its worth during the turbulent 1980s. The currency was later changed back to pounds, but at a much higher rate. In October 2005, al-Bashir's government negotiated an end to the Second Sudanese Civil War, leading to a referendum in the south, resulting in the separation of the south into the separate country of South Sudan. In September 2012, Sudanese President Omar al-Bashir opened the country's first gold refinery to produce 328 tons of gold annually, and it is speculated to be one of the largest such constructions in Africa. Still in 2012, Bashir proposed setting up a continent-wide space agency in Africa. In a statement, he said, "I'm calling for the biggest project, an African space agency. Africa must have its space agency. It will liberate Africa from technology domination." This followed previous calls in 2010 by the African Union to conduct a feasibility study that would draw up a roadmap for the creation of the African Space Agency. Al-Bashir has achieved economic growth in Sudan. This was pushed further by the drilling and extraction of oil. Many northern Sudanese and many Africans and Arabs perceive Bashir as a popularly elected president, the statesman who signed the landmark 2005 Comprehensive Peace Agreement, ending the 22-year war with the South, the leader who broke the power of Sudan's Islamists, who once harbored Osama bin Laden, and a man unfairly maligned and traduced by Western powers locked in the old colonial mindset and covetous of Sudan's vast mineral wealth. Khartoum. Khartoum is not only the capital of Sudan, but the political, cultural, and commercial center of the nation. It is a federal presidential representative democratic republic. The city was established 24 kilometers north of the ancient city of Suba in 1821 by Ibrahim Pasha, the son of Egypt's ruler Mohammed Ali Pasha, who had just incorporated Sudan into his realm. Originally, Khartoum served as an outpost for the Egyptian army, but the settlement quickly grew into a regional center of trade. It also became a focal point for the slave trade. Later, it became the administrative center of Sudan and official capital. Khartoum features a hot desert climate with a dry season occurring during winter time. The climate is extremely arid for most of the year, with about 9 months where average rainfall is lower than 5 millimeters. The very irregular, very brief rainy season lasts about 1 month, as the maximum rainfall is recorded in August with about 75 millimeters. Khartoum is one of the hottest major cities on Earth, based with its annual daily mean temperature with about 30 degrees Celsius. In the 21st century, Khartoum has developed based on Sudan's oil wealth. The center of the city has three lined streets. Khartoum has the highest concentration of economic activity in the country. Among the city's industries are printing, glass, manufacturing, food processing, and textiles. One of Sudan's largest refineries is located in northern Khartoum. The largest museum in all of Sudan, the National Museum of Sudan, can also be found in Khartoum. Khartoum is home to a small botanical garden in the Morgan district of the city. Khartoum is home to several clubs, such as the Sailing Club, the German Club, the Greek Hotel, the Coptic Club, the Syrian Club, and the International Club. Khartoum was rewarded the Arab Capital of Culture in 2005. Modern buildings in Khartoum are on the rise due to the economic growth. In Sudan, education is free and compulsory for children aged 6 to 13 years. Primary education consists of 8 years, followed by 3 years of secondary education. The primary language at all levels is Arabic. In 2001, the World Bank estimated that primary enrollment was 46% of eligible pupils and 21% of secondary students. The literacy rate is 70.2% of total population, with male consisting 79.6% and female 60.8%. By 2006, there were 27 public universities, 5 private universities, 9 public technical colleges, and 46 private colleges. The University of Khartoum is the largest and oldest university in Sudan. The University of Khartoum was founded as Gordon Memorial College in 1902 and established in 1956 when Sudan gained independence. Since that date, the University of Khartoum has been recognized as a top university and a high-ranked academic institution in Sudan and Africa. It features several institutes, academic units, and research centers. Onto the second.
Bye.
Until the second half of 2008, Sudan's economy boomed on the back of increases in oil production, high oil prices, and large inflows of foreign direct investment. GDP growth registered more than 10% per year in 2006 and 2007. From 1997 to date, Sudan has been working with the International Monetary Fund to implement macroeconomic reforms, including a managed float of the exchange rate. Sudan began exporting crude oil in the last quarter of 1999. Agricultural production remains important because it employs 80% of the workforce and contributes a third of GDP. Sudan has a developed infrastructure compared to most of sub-Saharan Africa, and many projects are taking place to develop it even further all across the country. Taking a look at Sudan's media landscape, one will realize that the country enjoys freedom of press to a certain degree, which is not very common in other African states. Journalists and the papers they serve, although subject to government censorship, operate with more freedom and independence than in most neighboring countries or Arab states. Sudan has a large number of local and national newspapers, both private and state-owned. Before the 1989 coup, Sudan had a lively press, with most political parties publishing a variety of periodicals. In Khartoum, 22 daily papers were published, 19 in Arabic and 3 in English. Altogether, the country had 55 daily or weekly newspapers and magazines. In present-day Sudan, Sudan Television Broadcasting Corporation airs radio programming in Arabic, English, French and Swahili. The major national dailies are published in Arabic or English. In 1990, there were an estimated 250,000 television sets. Now, there are about 1 million in the country and about 6 million radio receivers. It will be incomplete to talk about Sudan without mentioning telecommunications, as it is one of the very crucial sectors of any economy. Sudan had telecommunication services as early as 1897. All of the organizations established to deliver telecommunication services were government-owned. The liberalization and privatization of the telecommunication sector, the policies, the regulations and plans adopted by the government of the Sudan have created a capital-attracting, pro-competitive policy environment that have fostered the build-up of a modern, fully digital infrastructure in the country and furnished a climate suited to enhance information and communications technology, ICT development nationwide. One of such investments in telecommunications is Sudatel Telecommunications Group, STG. STG is one of the leading telecommunications companies in the region, serving the needs of customers in Sudan and Africa. Since its foundation on 13 September 1993, STG has grown steadily from local to regional markets, setting a good example for privatization policy. STG is the bridge for telecommunications movement between the Arab world, Africa, and the rest of the world. STG controls and distributes slightly above 5,000 kilometers of optical fiber across the national territory. Sudatel offers various telecommunication services such as mobile services, fixed line services, as well as carrier and wholesale services, and keeping its competitive edge with other companies. It equally provides services in 2G, 3G, and NGN technology levels. STG services are expanded into many cities and rural areas, achieving the widest coverage and most significant presence. STG's infrastructure integrates well together in harmony with all the modern elements of modern communications in optical fiber, networks, copper and wireless networks, so that all these networks are based on a common technology base, which is the best and most modern in the field of communication. Sudatel now runs a telecommunications business in some African states, including Mauritania, Senegal, Ghana and Guinea-Conakry, covering the areas of mobile, fixed internet and broadband services. STG is the first Sudanese company to be listed on the regional stock market. On 4th July 1997, it was enlisted on Khartoum Stock Exchange. On 6th November 2000, it was enlisted on Bahraini Stock Market and on Abu Dhabi Stock Market on 31st March 2003. The incumbent Omar al-Bashir is not relenting efforts to see that Sudan becomes a reference nation in Africa, and why not the world at large in the nearest future.